I am extremely passionate about nature. From a very early age, I've always been in love with nature. I wanted to become a scientist, but for some reason, I become a great cricketer instead. Obviously, God knows what he wanted for me. But I've always still kept in touch with nature, you know, been in love with nature, and always wanted to see the planet, you know, become a pure place for us to live. As I got older, I realized more and more the importance of preserving plants and animals, and because of the contribution that and the importance of these living entities to our planet. I can recall when I was a little boy, I used to argue with my mother when she used to cut down plants from around the yard. I didn't quite know at that time, I was maybe about 7 or 8, how important plants were. But for some reason, I was in love with plants. I loved to see them, and I knew that they contributed to us breathing oxygen, and that's all I knew at the time. So I used to argue with her about cutting down plants and stuff like that. As I got older, I got a better understanding of the importance of plants and animals. We have a problem in the Caribbean with hurricanes. For many years, you know, there were no hurricanes, and then all of a sudden, I think it was early 1980s, we started getting a lot of hurricanes. And no doubt that was as a result of global warming. The place has started to become really, really hot, and the hurricanes have affected the Caribbean region very, very terribly. We've lost a lot of lovely beaches. You know, we boast of having some of the best beaches in the world. And because of all these hurricanes we've been having the last, you know, 30 years or so, a number of our beautiful beaches have been destroyed. Our beautiful Caribbean islands have been destroyed. We still have some natural beauty, but if we don't pay attention to the causes of these problems, I think eventually maybe some of our islands will disappear. Sea level is rising quite fast, and you know, we really have to do something in order to stop this thing from happening. Another one of my concern is the fact that we use so much fossil fuel. I believe in God, I believe in science, and I believe that God is the greatest scientist ever. And he, whatever he does, he knows exactly what he's doing. And there's a reason why, you know, there's fossil fuels below the surface of the earth, there for a reason. And when we dig down there and take this out, we're causing a problem. Not only to the atmosphere above, but we're creating a void down there. I'm afraid maybe someday that parts of the earth will collapse because we're taking so much stuff from beneath there. Obviously, burning fossil fuel, you know, create a lot of carbon in the atmosphere, create a lot of problems for us. And I think that in this day and age, with all the scientific skills that we have, we should be able to use nature to harness energy. We have natural sunlight every single day. I don't see no reason why we can't use that. We have the wind, the natural wind, which is always there. We also have the sea that we can use to harness energy. And, you know, I just don't understand why up to this day we are still digging into the earth to use fossil fuel for our needs. I think it's down to greed. There are people who make a lot of money from fossil fuel, and they don't want to give this up. So I'm very passionate about that, and I would fight and I would argue for us to get away from that. Please excuse me, I'm being driven as I speak, so please excuse me. As human beings, we have a massive responsibility to try and preserve this planet. It's very evident that things are changing, and it's getting worse very, very fast. And if we don't really do what we need to do, there are lots of educational programs out there, There's lots on the internet everywhere, but there are a few who don't really care. All they're interested in is the money that they make. They don't want to listen to science. They don't want to listen to the scientists and do what we have to do in order to preserve our beloved planet. So that's my position. I'm very, very concerned. Simple things like when I go shopping and they ask to give me a receipt, I tell them, no, I don't want any receipts. Please save the paper, because it means that, you know, we are cutting down more trees and we shouldn't be doing that. We have the technology where you can receive a receipt via email. So why should we have to be printing on paper? I think we should get away from using paper, which means that we are cutting down trees. We should get into the habit of planting more trees. I mean, I spend a lot of time in my yard, in my garden, especially during this COVID times, planting flowers, plants, you know, vegetables, and growing trees, lots of palm trees and stuff like that, because, you know, I realize that we need to cool the planet down, and trees play a very important part in cooling the planet down. So that's it in a nutshell for me. And I would just like to congratulate the moderator and all who are involved. It's a very, very important cause, and I'm very happy to be part of it. And you have my contact details, so if ever you wanted me to be in touch and to be an ambassador for this cause, I'll be more than happy to do so. So thank you very much, and thanks for having me on this forum.